Welcome, in this video are some well-known stories from England's capital, London Dungeons, which is situated on Tully Street, that was first mentioned in 1561 Stuart period as Barnes Street. The name Tully came from a time of corruption of the church St. Olave that had its name changed to St. Tullus. On the 22nd of June 1861, a fire started in a warehouse at Cotton Wharf in Tully Street. The fire raged for 2 days before it was exterminated by the London Fire Engine Establishment. Due to the fire passing from one building to the next, it took 2 whole weeks to be fully extinguished. As insurance companies owned the original fire brigade, they put their premiums up after the blaze to force the government to take over, which they eventually did, and that's how the Metropolitan Fire Brigade Act came into force in 1865. The warehouses of Hayes Wharf that burnt down are names of buildings in the area. Since the wharf was filled in the 1980s to expand the area with shopping facilities, the remnants are a private hospital named St. Olaf House, and a couple of others are named after some well-known ship merchants. A 1542 map highlights 2 buildings. One was known as the Cage, which was used for drunks to spend the night and they were released the next day when sober. The other building was used for punishing fraudulent traders known as the Pillory. These buildings became home to the London Dungeons, which was formerly a wax museum. London Dungeons was opened by Annabel Geddes in 1974, and was relocated to Tully Street in 2013. The current owner is Merlin Entertainment after buying the attraction from Varden Attractions, before Merlin Entertainment added more ghastly shows for the public. The original attraction kept a more historical base and provided guests with facts about the Jack the Ripper massacres, and the Great Fire of London. After the tourists have gone, many staff members have claimed to hear whispering, unexplained noises and seen apparitions. One apparition in particular is a woman in Victorian attire sitting on the end of a bed. Hampton Court. 1514 is when the construction began on the previous property of the Order of St. John of Jerusalem. This palace used to be a residence for Henry VIII's chief minister Cardinal Thomas Wolsey. It came into possession by the king after Thomas Wolsey gave him the palace. Much of Thomas Wolsey's architecture can be seen today, like the base court, which contained 4 to 4 lodgings for guests, and Cardinal Wolsey's rooms, which were private rooms for the cardinal. The clock court was saved for the best guests like King Henry VIII, who stayed in 1525 immediately after completion, with having the most luxurious rooms, and the clock tower where the seal of Thomas Wolsey can be seen today. While Henry had the palace in his possession, he expanded the home to what visitors see today. The first area of the palace to be expanded was the kitchens, so the king could put on marvelous feasts for his courtiers that consisted of approximately 1,000 men. The Great Hall, which is known to be the last medieval hall to be built for an English monarch. Henry also erected a clock on the tower now known as Anne Boleyn's Gate. When the River Thames was at low tide, many rapids occurred. That's one of the reasons why this clock let the public know the time for high waters. This clock contains some marvelous Tudor engineering, as not only states the time and tides, but the date, the month, phases of the moon, the quarter of the year, the star sign and the sun. Now this palace is owned by Queen Elizabeth II. Hampton Court and St. James Palace are the only two that are surviving from Henry VIII's reign. When Henry died, it was a century after when remodeling of the palace was started by Edward III. Unfortunately for Edward, his plans ceased prematurely. This is why visitors can see 2 contrasts of building styles. This palace was never resided in by the living again after King George II. Only the spirit of Lady Jane Seymour, Henry VIII's third wife, is said to reside at Hampton Court Palace. Tower of London. When William the Conqueror overthrew the Saxon King Harold in the Battle of Hastings 1066, He wanted to show how powerful he was and also wanted to protect his new land. In 1070, William built a large fortress on the River Thames, which dominated the skyline. Old Saxon people were forced in helping to build the keep for the new king. The stone arrived from France and the stonemasons were from Normandy, which they worked together for 20 years. Throughout the centuries the keep was expanded. Most notable expansions were those in Henry III and Edward I's reign, when the moat had an expansion, adding a huge wall to tighten the defences along with towers. In 1800 coins were stopped being produced in the Tower's mint along with armour and weapons. Till this day, the tower protects royal jewels. Within 1471, when the War of the Roses was taking place over the British landscape, Henry VI was assassinated in the Tower of London. 12 years later in 1483, two princes went missing while staying at the Tower for safety. Their skeletons were found behind the walls in 1674, but it was not until 1933 when it was proved. The skeletons of two young children were the princes aged 10 and 12 at the time of their disappearance. The yeoman warders, known popular today as beefeaters, used to protect any monarch everywhere while travelling. It was not until the command of Henry VIII that some yeomen were to stay and protect the tower. The yeoman warders stand out in their red uniforms and black beaver fur hats. They also keep ceremonies that have been around for years, like locking and unlocking the tower, also a gun salute, where a cannon is fired towards the wharf. Over the centuries the tower had been a place for good times, like visitors viewing exotic animals that were given as a present to the monarch, although, at the time these animals were gifted, people of England were not sure what they ate or drank, so they were forced to consume weird things like alcohol was given to an elephant. The animals moved from the tower in 1900 to what is now known as London Zoo. Another well-known part of the tower is the White Tower, which Henry VIII modernized at the time for his new wife to be Anne Boleyn. The couple stayed in the White Tower night before their wedding, which took place in Westminster Abbey. In 1536 Anne Boleyn stayed in the White Tower again, this time waiting for her execution. The crimes Anne had against her were adultery and treason. Anne Boleyn was beheaded by the sword within the tower walls and her spirit is said to haunt the green where she was beheaded. The Tower of London did not really become known as a prison until the Tudor era. Elizabeth I was sent to the tower in her younger years by her half-sister Mary I, as Mary thought Elizabeth was plotting against Mary so Elizabeth could have the throne. Mary I also had Lady Jane Grey imprisoned in the tower. When Lady Jane Grey arrived at the tower for the crown, Mary I declared the crown belonged to herself, not Lady Grey. Sir Walter Raleigh was imprisoned at the Tower after being arrested in 1603. He was charged with treason against James I. Guy Fawkes was imprisoned for his attempt to blow up the Parliament. The recent bloodiest moment within the Tower's walls was when German spies were shot in the midst of the war. Going back to the year 1278, 269 Jewish people were hanged at the Tower of London after 600 were imprisoned. With the turmoil throughout the Tower of London's history, has led many to believe that ghosts wander the modern-day attraction, a bear being one. This bear's spirit is thought to be from the time when animals were the main attraction and is also believed that the bear's ghost jumps out at visitors. A spirit is thought to haunt the Queen Hall of the Tower by Elizabeth I's cousin Arbella Stuart, who was imprisoned for marrying without royal permission. Arbella Stuart died of starvation during his time in the Tower. 10 Bells Pub. This pub can date back to the year 1755 when the name changed from 8 Bells Ale House to 10, due to Christ Church having their new chimes installed. The location of this pub was 12 Red Lion Street, which was not far from the location today, which is 84 Commercial Street, which was known as 33 Church Street. Truman, Hanbury, Buxton & Co. had to move the pub to its current location because of demolition on Red Lion Street. The interior of Ten Bells is Victorian. There is also a mural inside that commemorates the weaving heritage entitled Spitalfields in Ye Olden Time, which was painted by Ian Harper. This pub is also said to be haunted, as staff and visitors alike have felt cold spots with no explanation. An apparition of a man in Victorian attire is said to appear and disappear. Another apparition is that of Annie Chapman, who was brutally murdered by the guy in our next story. Jack the Ripper was an unknown man who killed five women between August and November 1888 in London's Whitechapel district. Even though many murders were committed between 1888 and 1892 that could be respectfully associated with Jack the Ripper, only five are really known. August 31st was when the Ripper's first victim, Mary Ann Nichols, aged 43, was found. For 3 months Mary worked as a servant in the workhouse before she left. Mary was a drinker and looking after people who were constantly sober, got to her slightly. After that she drifted from guest house to guest house, selling her womanly goods to pay for a bed for the night. Mary was last seen on Osborne Street walking towards Whitechapel Road, by her friend Emily Holland. A cart driver had spotted something laid on the floor by a stable entrance on Duruard Street, which is now known as Bucks Row. It was not until the cart man was inspecting the suspicious object that he noticed it was a body of a woman. He did not hesitate in finding a police officer. Mary's throat had been cut and her abdomen was sliced open, leaving her bowel to protrude out of her body, but no organs were missing. Since her death there have been sightings of an apparition in the same area that Mary did. The apparition is said to emit green light. Annie Chapman, Jack the Ripper's second victim, who made an earning from handcrafts like antimacassars and crochets, Annie also sold flowers as well as her womanly goods, to keep paying for her lodgings. Annie was known to have a rivalry going on with one of the other lodgers, which led to a brawl in the Britannic public house, which left Annie with bruised breasts and eyes. A day or so later, Annie had something to eat and took some pills before leaving at midnight to earn some money for her bed. The last time Annie was seen alive was when Annie was talking to a gentleman behind a house situated on Hanbury Street. A few hours later the resident from another home had to go into his garden to check on a cellar. That is when the screams of, "No," were heard, but the resident did not investigate. Not long after the resident of 29 Hanbury Street went into their back garden, that is when Annie's body was discovered. The man quickly got the attention of three men to let them know about the discovery. They all ran down Commercial Street to find police officers while shouting a woman had been killed. Within minutes several police officers were on the scene. Annie died with the same protrusions as Mary, with the abdomen and throat being cut. Annie had membranes within the brain and lungs that were in advanced stage, so probably Annie would not have long to live if not murdered. Annie's spirit is said to haunt the pub named after the killer Jack the Ripper. The pub had to have its name changed back to the Ten Bells after so much controversy. Elizabeth Stride is believed to be Jack the Ripper's third victim, who died on the 30th of September, had recently become single and worked as a cleaner for lodgings and Jewish residents. Before Elizabeth was killed she was seen by a police officer speaking to a man on Burns Street, now known as Henricks Street. Few hours later Elizabeth's body was found by a steward for the International Working Men's Educational Club in Dutfield's Yard. Elizabeth's neck was sliced open like Jack the Ripper's previous victims. Dutfield's Yard is now a school. On certain occasions outside the school gates noises of crying out due to a woman struggling can be heard. Some believe it's the last remnants of Elizabeth's life. Catherine Eddowes, who was a hop picker, arrived in London 2 days before she was murdered, and known to become Jack the Ripper's second victim in 24 hours. Early hours of the morning on the 30th of September, Catherine was seen by three witnesses walking down a walkway known as Church Passage. After emerging out the passage, another witness had seen Catherine talking to a gentleman. Within an hour, Catherine's body was discovered in Mitre Square by a policeman. Catherine had her neck sliced open as well as disemboweled. Some people say they have seen Catherine's apparition on the anniversary of her death, laying in the same spot as she died. Greenwich Foot Tunnel. Work began on this tunnel in 1899 and finished in 1902. Till to this day, these tunnels are provided to the public, so they can cross under the Thames for free. These tunnels have been equipped with closed-circuit television, signs to allow pedestrians the lift availability as the lifts are in operation 24/7. The lighting in these tunnels has been upgraded, the rotundas have been re-roofed, and also the structure has been renewed or replaced, which has been done behind the scenes away from the public. Although, with this tunnel being updated and security enhanced, many still will not walk the tunnel, which takes about 15 minutes. Many people have felt uneasy walking through the tunnel, like people watching or hearing noises similar to someone walking right behind. Two apparitions, one of a man and the other a woman, have also been seen within the tunnels wearing Victorian attire. They are said to hold hands while walking down the tunnel before they disappear. Voices are also supposed to be heard while no one else is around, and temperature fluctuations in areas are also presumably felt by those that have walked through. The Victor Wind Museum of Curiosities is situated on Mare Street. The building used to be a call center before Victor Wind turned the building into the museum. His collection consists of artwork by Austin Osman Spare. A section of the museum is a dedication to Dandy. Dodo bones are also on view for the public to see, as well as bones and a taxidermy of the giant anteater. This museum holds the largest pieces of work by Leonora Corrington and also used rubber contraception that was used by the band Rolling Stones. In the collection is Sebastian Hawley's nails that was taken after his crucifixion, also archive material and drawings by Stephen Tennant, as well as a selection of shrunken heads. A collection of tribal art can be viewed by the public that has been collected from the Congo and New Guinea, and a two-headed lamb is on view too. Guests and staff alike have heard unexplained noises, strange shadows, and people have also encountered being touched. Strange smells have also been noted within the museum. The Viaduct Tavern was built in 1865 and remodeled by Arthur Dixon in 1898. This Grade II listed building is situated on Newgate Street. It has kept its Victorian interior from when it was known as a gin house. This pub is also situated across from what used to be Newgate Prison. Also, the Viaduct Tavern overlooks the area where multiple executions took place. Before that building was a gin house, it used to be a prison for those that were in debt. If anyone ventures into the basement, the old remnants of those ages can still be seen, as some cells are there to this day. This tavern is said to be haunted by a poltergeist, a story that is known to happen, is an ex-landlord was alone when the lights started flickering, doors slammed, and an unknown presence also spoke to the landlord. The landlord was not quiet about his ordeal, as his wife heard the commotion, and she was the one to rescue him from his ordeal. Another story is related to some carpet fitters, as a new carpet was ordered and they were getting ready to lay it. Just before the men were able to lay the carpet, something that could not be seen picked up the rolled up carpet and slammed it on the floor with some force. Not only does the Viaduct Tavern entertain their guests with fine food and a good selection of cask ales, they will also invite intrigued customers into the basement to view the cells for themselves, and if anyone feels like they would try out the spookier side, this tavern holds seances as part of an annual event. Brompton Cemetery. This cemetery, which was designed by Benjamin Board and started construction in 1839 and opened in 1840, was once privately owned. Now the ownership belongs to the monarch. This cemetery has 205,000 resting places and is still open to new burials to this day after burials were prevented between the years 1952 and 1966. Only people that could be buried in Brompton Cemetery in this period were families of the deceased already buried within the cemetery and Polish interments. Brompton Cemetery has two entrances. The North Lodge entrance is on Old Brompton Road, and the South Lodge entrance, which is on Fulham Road. Recently, the Community Funds and National Lottery Heritage helped restore the chapel to its former glory. Its damage could be due to weathering, its age, or even the events of World War II, as this cemetery did get some bombs dropped on these grounds by the English enemies. Brompton Cemetery is Grade 1 listed, however there are some monuments are Grade 2 listed, like Burnside Monument, which is commemorated to Iris Burnside, who was on the SS Lusitania before it sank. Iris drowned due to the incident. Percy Edgar Lambert, who was the first person to drive an automobile over 100 miles an hour, also has a Grade 2 monument. There are some well-known people buried within Brompton Cemetery. Emmeline Pankhurst, who founded the suffragettes, is buried within this cemetery. Same with Frances Braun Lyndon, who was the fiancée of John Keats, an English poet. Frederick Bulwer Chatterton, who was the lessee of the Theatre Royal in Drury Lane from 1866 to 1879, is also buried in the cemetery. Same with Dr. Benjamin Golding, who founded the West London Infirmary, which is now known as Charing Cross Hospital. Dr. Golding was dedicated to treating the poor and he wrote two books, one about St. Thomas's Hospital and the other about the West London Infirmary. Also in this cemetery lies Robert Keeler, who was an acting manager, comedian and a female impressionist in the 19th century. He also played a part in the first stage adaptation of Mary Shelley's novel Frankenstein. Christopher Sebastian Lambert, known as Kit Lambert, who managed the band The Who, is also buried in Brompton Cemetery. Same with Frederick Richard Sleyland, who owned a fleet of 25 steamships that were used for transatlantic crossings. He was also a profound art collector. Blanche Roosevelt Tucker, who was an American opera singer as well as an author. Blanche is possibly better known for the role of Mabel in Gilbert and Sullivan's play The Pirates of Penzance, which premiered in 1879 on Broadway. Born in 1880 and died in 1955, the legendary footballer Jack Whitley is buried in this cemetery. He used to play for Aston Villa, Chelsea, Darwin, Everton, Leeds City, Lincoln City and Stoke. There was a legend about Long Wolf, who was a Sioux warrior buried in Brompton Cemetery. It was later discovered that Lone Wolf returned to America to be buried in the Pine Ridge Reservation, South Dakota, where Oglala Sioux tribe resided. However, in 1997, with the grave was exhumed to see if the legend was true, a 2-year-old girl was found who is said to be Star Ghost Dog, who died by falling of a horse in Buffalo Cody's show, which performed in Earl's Court in 1892. Star Ghost Dog was buried with an unidentified Englishman. It was also planned that Sir Arthur Sullivan of Gilbert and Sullivan would be buried in Brompton Cemetery along with Sullivan's family, although Queen Victoria intervened and highly recommended they be buried at St. Paul's Cathedral. Between the years 1854 and 1939, Brompton Cemetery became a burial cemetery for the military. In the northwest corner of the cemetery is where the Royal Hospital Chelsea bought the plot and is easily identifiable to this day, as there is a monument of an obelisk. In the south of the cemetery is where the Brigade of Guards own a plot, and there is known to be 289 Commonwealth Service personnel from World War I and World War II. Stories have appeared about apparitions vanishing into alcoves. Some apparitions are also seen walking down the steps into the crypts, as well as just vanishing into walls. Many people would also state this cemetery is not haunted. Haunted Gatehouse. The Gatehouse pub in Highgate is a place that can give guests an eerie feeling as soon as they walk through the door. A pub has been documented on this site since 1337, as stated in St. Pancras records, which was at the entrance to the estate of Bishop of Ely. Within the 1500, the documents state a violent attack on a hermit that had been forced out of his home in St. Michael's in Highgate by the vicar of St. Pancras and his parishioners. The hermit then had to hide in the steeple of his hermitage. The gatehouse known to people today was built in 1670 by Edward Cutler. The most notable people who are said to have drank in the gatehouse pub are George Cruikshank, who was a famous illustrator of his time, and Charles Dickens, who was an author and his novels are still well known today. Lord Byron is said to have drunk at the pub, as well as the infamous Dick Turpin. 1839 was the first meeting of the Highgate Literary and Scientific Institution. In 1874, an article was published by George Walter Thornbury about cattle drivers establishing a club within the gatehouse pub, and they created a ceremony called swearing on the horns. The Freemasons' Lodge also used the gatehouse pub as their meeting place until they relocated to a new location in 1891. When viewing this pub from the outside, it looks older due to the Tudor facade, but this pub was remodeled in 1905. The Gatehouse pub is now owned by the Wetherspoons franchise. There is also an auditorium and theatre upstairs in the building that dates back to 1895. Before the area was a theatre, it was used as an Victorian cinema. The staff are not permitted to enter the cellar alone due to eerie unexplained activity. A widowed woman known as Mother Mance is said to have haunted the gatehouse pub after being murdered. One customer was apparently attacked in 1966 by something he could not see with his own eyes. A barmaid also had a similar experience while working her shift. She felt like something unseen was strangling her. Both the victims were awake when these events apparently happened to them. A former landlord also quit due to seeing an apparition go upstairs. Some have also witnessed a figure dressed in black, which only makes itself known to those who drink alone. When this dark-faced figure turns to look at the person, it is said the figure's face is disfigured, and many class this apparition to be the notorious Highgate vampire. Francis Bacon, who was a magician and philosopher and worked on a new project of freezing food in the Highgate area, when he died of pneumonia while testing one of his theories, he placed stuffing in a chicken that rested it in snow till it froze. The head of British Psychic and Occult Society David Ferrand believes the Gatehouse pub is situated on ley lines, which apparently help the spirits to travel from the cemetery known as the Highgate Cemetery to visit the pub. Some people believe this is why a man wearing Jacobean attire has been noticed walking throughout the building and into the walls. London Bridge. It is thought the first bridge over the River Thames was built by the Romans in 46 Anno Domini. The second bridge recorded was made of wood, where a woman who was thought to be a witch was drowned in 984. Her son was supposed to go through the same punishment, but it is thought he escaped. The bridge was thought to have been pulled down in 1014 by the Viking King Olaf and his men, who sailed up the Thames and strapped ropes around the bridge and sailed away full speed. The Vikings were teamed up with the Saxon King Ethelred while this was taking place. The Danes who held London at this time were helpless. Peter Kolakirch, who was a man of cloth, designed a bridge for the River Thames in 1176. After 33 years, the bridge was completed in 1909. The bridge was supported by 20 Gothic-style arches with drawbridges that allowed ships in and out of the River Thames, but no enemies were able to get in at all, and was 20 feet wide and 300 yards long. It was thought that the bridge would last 600 years. The bridge was also fitted with water wheels that first grounded up wheat to feed the citizens of London. Afterwards, the merchants built shops on top of London Bridge, but in the year 1212 a disaster struck the bridge, which left many citizens trapped between flames, and many were burnt alive. In 1304 a new practice was in order by the monarch, where the heads of criminals were placed on London Bridge and Oliver Cromwell's head was part of the collection. Due to this punishment to warn other potential criminals, London Bridge became nicknamed as Traitor's Bridge. During 1557, the drawbridges were replaced by Nonsuch House, and tunnels run through the building at street level. The wood was shipped from Holland and no nails were used to build Nonsuch House. The water wheels began being used to pump water into London in 1580. A maidservant left a pile of ashes under the stairs in 1623, which caused another drastic fire on London Bridge. Homes and shops were once again destroyed. After this incident, merchants began moving their businesses off the bridge. 1657 homes were demolished on the bridge. The central arch was widened, same with the bridge itself, to allow more traffic to cross the Thames. Parliament appointed a committee in 1821 to assess the condition of London Bridge. Due to the damage that had occurred by the big freeze, many plans for the new bridge were rejected, till finally the bridge plans were approved in 1824, and the architect was John Rennies. The new bridge was built 100 feet west from the original bridge. The first brick was laid by the Mayor of London. After 6 years of construction, the new London Bridge was opened in 1831 by King William IV and his wife Queen Adelaide. After the bridge was opened, the king gave the go-ahead to get the old bridge demolished. London Bridge could not take the strain due to the traffic becoming heavily populated, and it was starting to sink in the bank of the Thames. The City of London decided to place the bridge into an auction in 1962. That is when Robert P. McCulloch won the bid for $2,460,000 in 1968. And another $7 million was spent on transporting the bridge, which took 3 years to dismantle. During the dismantlement of London Bridge, all the bricks, steel and lighting were numbered before being shipped to the port of Long Beach in California. From there the bridge was transported to Lake Havasu City, where reassembly began in 1968. Even to this day, if people look closely at the bridge, numbers can be seen from the dismantlement. London Bridge was opened once again in 1971, which quickly put Lake Havasu City on the tourists' map, as the bridge is known worldwide as being the world's largest antique. The lanterns are made from smelted down cannons that were used by Napoleon Bonaparte's army. London Bridge is hollow inside to cater for traffic crossing the bridge. The steel bridge is also faced with granite that was originally mined from Dartmoor, which has reduced the bridge's weight by 100,000 tons. The movie Bridge Across Time, which was released in 1985, and the movie Day of the Wolves, released in 1971, featured the London Bridge. Bats have also made London Bridge home since it has been in America. Swallows have also made the bridge home by building nests on the underside of the bridge by using mud. There is also energy-efficient LED lighting on London Bridge, which still gives a vintage look, as it seems the original gas lights are burning. London Bridge is the second most visited attraction by tourists in Arizona. The first main attraction is the Grand Canyon. London Bridge is thought to be haunted by a British policeman and a woman wearing nothing but black. Thank you for watching. If you have enjoyed any of my content, please leave a like and subscribe and press that notification bell so you will be the first to know when a new video will be posted.